We're going to let you go, Brad. The speaker is out, and we're going to listen in.
Vote on the House floor indicates there's bipartisan opposition to Senator Reid's proposal. The House yesterday sent our second bill to end this crisis to the Senate. It's a reasonable, responsible approach that will end this crisis, get our economy moving again, and get Americans back to work. And the only thing standing in the way of the House proposal over in the Senate is the President and Senator Reid. It's time for them to tell us what they're for. Time to tell us how they're going to get us out of the cul-de-sac that they've driven our country into. And so we're hoping that we'll hear from them soon about their plan for how we end this crisis.
I don't want to linger too long on the spectacle that's going on over in the Senate, but it is worth noting that you have the majority, in effect, refusing to accept a vote on their own proposal. We know the Reid proposal will not pass the Senate. We know it will not pass the House. And my view is we ought to end that charade and get serious. Now, in the category of getting serious, I've spoken to both the President and the Vice President within the last hour. We are now fully engaged, the Speaker and I, with the one person in America out of 307 million people who can sign a bill into law. I'm confident and optimistic that we're going to get an agreement in the very near future and resolve this crisis in the best interest of the American people.
Couple questions.
Mr. Speaker, question for you. The chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff is in Afghanistan, and he was asked by a number of soldiers whether they're going to get their checks next week. How can you even allow these soldiers to wonder whether they're going to get paid?
I think Senator McConnell and I are both confident that we're going to be able to come to some agreement with the White House and end this impasse.
The vote for various reasons the past couple of days, but did this buy time where we could have had this realistically worked out with a bipartisan agreement next door?
We could have had this bill finished early this past week. There was a bipartisan agreement between myself and the Senate leaders to move the underlying bill that we moved through the House yesterday. And if the President, all he had to do was say yes, and that bill would have moved quickly through both the House and the Senate. And so we've wasted a week that we didn't need to waste. And now we've been driven into this cul-de-sac, and it's time for the President to decide how we're going to get out of it.
Specifically, what gives you confidence you're going to get an agreement?
In spite of our differences, I think we're dealing with reasonable, responsible people who want this crisis to end as quickly as possible. And I'm confident that we will.
Yeah, let me just add. You know, our country is not going to default for the first time in history. That is not going to happen. We now have, I think, a level of seriousness with the right people at the table that we needed and thought we had, as the Speaker indicated last weekend. We're going to get a result.
You guys have both proven that you cannot do this on your own, that it's going to take a bipartisan vote. Now you're saying that you're waiting on the President and Harry Reid to get something to you guys. How are you guys planning to work together with 3 days left to get something done?
We have all worked together for most of the year to try to avoid this. But Senator Reid, Senator McConnell, and I had a solid agreement last Sunday. It was the President who derailed that agreement. It's time for the President to tell us what he's for. It's time for the President to outline how we get out of this cul-de-sac that he's driven us into.
Yeah, could I just add, I think we all know that if the President decides to reach an agreement with us, the Democrats, most of them, will fall in line. He is the leader of the Democratic Party. He is the President of the United States. He needs to indicate what he will sign, and we are in those discussions now.
Do you still have an agreement?
You anticipate something by Monday. Is that an important deadline considering markets?
I'm not going to put any deadlines, but I think it's pretty clear, it should be clear to all of you, that Senator McConnell and I believe that we're going to be able to come to some agreement to end this crisis as soon as possible. Thanks.
The Republican leaders up at the Capitol, and a little bit of news from that with Senator McConnell reporting that he has spoken with the president and vice president within the hour, reporting on that. David Drucker of Roll Call tweeting that out, quote, "We are now fully engaged with Obama, confident we are going to get an agreement." The words of Senator McConnell in that briefing.